Morning, everyone. You know, Republicans have voted twice to replace the sequester. President, as you're all aware, insisted that he not have to deal with the debt ceiling twice and insisted that the backstop for the work of the super committee be the sequester. But I don't think the president's focused on trying to find a solution to the sequester. President has been traveling all over the country, and today going down to Newport News in order to use our military men and women as a prop in yet another campaign rally to support his tax hikes. Now, the American people know the president gets more money, they're just going to spend it. And the fact is that he's gotten his tax hikes. It's time to focus on the real problem here in Washington, and that is spending. The president has known for 16 months that this sequester was looming out there when the super committee failed to come to an agreement. And so for 16 months, the president's been traveling all over the country holding rallies instead of sitting down with Senate leaders in order to try to forge an agreement over there in order to move a bill. We have moved a bill in the House twice. We should not have to move a third bill before the Senate gets off their ass and begins to do something.
Good morning. Speaker said the president's going to be in Newport News, Virginia, and talking to families in the Commonwealth. I can tell you, I'm concerned about families in the Commonwealth. I'm concerned because they're concerned about their future and the uncertainty which looms because of this sequester. Now, the president has said, well, he wants to compromise. But if you take a look at what's going on, there's been 4 years of spending increases, and now the president says we can't have any progress on this sequester unless we get the second tax hike in eight weeks. That's not compromise. Then he says your choice is going to be taking criminals off, letting criminals out of jails and onto the streets, or give me a tax increase. That's not compromise. That's a false choice. You know, we have tried in the House, as the Speaker said again, to bring forward measures that actually accomplish reform and cut spending. We've even taken things that the President had in his very own budget to say, please join us, and he won't accept those proposals unless we raise taxes. Now, it's time for the Senate to come together with us, sit down with the President, and let's get this resolved for the American people.
As many of you know, you've heard about this argument for quite some time. Let's put it in perspective. This idea came from the White House. When the House passed the bill twice, what did the president do? He threatened the veto if we dealt something different on sequestration. Now, as the time looms, the president does exactly what he continues to do. He does a roadshow. The fundamental question here the president has to decide: does he want to be president of a political party, or does he want to be president of the United States? It is time for leadership. It is time for him to engage and come down 1 mile, deal with the Senate, if he really wants to lead.
We are 3 days away from the president's plan taking effect unless the Senate takes action. The president proposed the sequester, the across-the-board cuts that disproportionately impact our military. And now he is on the road in Newport News today, over 180 miles from Washington, D.C. He's traveled over 5,000 miles the last 2 weeks. And we challenge him, Mr. President, travel a mile and a half up here to Capitol Hill. Sit down with Harry Reid and urge the Senate Democrats to take action. The president says that this is a bad idea, but yet he has not put forward an alternative idea. The Republicans in the House have twice taken action, twice passed legislation, the first time 300 days ago. What we need is for the president to stop using this as an excuse to raise taxes and turn it into an opportunity to start saving taxpayer dollars, start spending money more wisely. The American people, moms, dads, seniors, college students, children, they shouldn't be forced to lose their jobs or lose the opportunities that this country has to offer. It's time to get serious about the spending. And we need the president to lead and get off the campaign trail.
A proud Kansan by the name of William Allen White once said something to the effect that the truth will always come out if the facts are fairly and honestly on display. So let's review the facts. The facts are the sequester was the president's idea. It's a fact the House has twice passed legislation to replace the sequester with smarter cuts and reforms. It's a fact that the Senate has twice rejected our replacement and has set up another financial crisis. And it's a fact that the president threatened to veto any replacement to the sequester. It's also a fact that these cuts amount to about 2.5% of the federal budget. Find me an American family, a hardworking taxpayer that hasn't already cut over 2% out of their budgets at home without cutting essential things. There's a fact that says that we are going to take in more money this fiscal year than we have ever taken in before. The budget this year, we will spend more money this year than we spent last year, even if the sequester goes into effect. We will spend more money even if the sequester goes into effect. The fact is, when we accepted the president's sequester 18 months ago, we made a deal, a dollar for cuts for a dollar of spending or debt limit increase. If he wants to do the bait and switch now, we will have lied to our constituents by replacing those with tax increases. This leads you to the truth, and the truth is the president needs to come back from his campaign style tour, stop scaring people, and work with us to address the issue of the debt and the deficits, get the economy moving, and people back to work.
Yeah, we've all said the across-the-board spending reduction is the wrong way to do spending reduction, that it needs to be more targeted. That's why the House passed something last May to replace the sequester. That's why the House also passed in December last year to say this is a better way to do it. We have overspent the federal budget by $1 trillion now 5 years in a row. We cannot continue to do that. And so this perpetual statement of let's just postpone it, let's do it another time, let's delay it another month is the wrong way to do it. As has already been mentioned, this year now will be the highest amount of revenue in the history of the country. With the tax increases that just came on board with the fiscal cliff negotiations, now tax revenue will be the highest ever in the history of the nation. This is not an issue of if we just had a little more in taxes, we would solve this. We are overspending. We are spending more than we ever have. We have got to find a way to be able to slow down our spending to stabilize our economy so American families are not dealing with the crisis they're dealing with.